All right, welcome back here at Dungeon Port Studios. We will be going over some more of Subnautica. Let's see. Last time we left off, we had just finished building our main base here and getting it powered up and ready to go. Our next thing will be exploring the surrounding area and getting to the Aurora itself and going up inside of it. So, to go up inside of it, we will need some fire extinguishers and the what's it called? Propulsion cannon. So, our first thing we will be doing is seeing if we can get that propulsion cannon. We do have the radiation suit, so we can make it back over into this area. If you do not have the radiation suit, venture out along the Aurora, and as you go deeper down in this direction, you will find areas where you can actually get the lead that you need for your radiation suit itself. And with this, we can go a little bit farther and also pick up fish as we're going. If we're skilled enough. And let's see what we got here. Another piece of that. And let's check our inventory right now. We are empty, so. And we'll go ahead and scan that. Grab some materials. So we're coming up to that cliff that we couldn't get past before. We're gonna be a lookout for that giant creature that we've seen, while also seeing if we can collect some of the artifacts that we had seen right here. So we've got two fragments there. What box?
30 seconds.
There's a creature right up there. We don't want to anger them too much. So I'll stay on this side of the. going back over that way. That's good. But in the meantime, let's start making our way. Down and around. We'll pick up the quartz need along the way. And I hear someone saying, we should probably get some table coral if we want to pick up any of them. Do anything else in the outer section here? Acquired. And I agree that would be a very wise idea.
Stabilizing. situation that's losing power to you, maybe.
Alright, as you can see, we've set our beacon, and we've got most of our materials set up to our hotbar here. We do want to go in with very little stuff, because there is a lot of stuff inside the Aurora itself, I do wish I had the one more piece of equipment, which I think is this right here. Let's see. We need to scan one more of them. Let's see if we can find a piece or a box sitting around. I don't think we're going to find a box just sitting here. Alright, so we've got some new blueprints in here. Let's see what we've got. So we got a stasis rifle and propulsion cannon. We need to find one more of them. We need one more piece of the mobile vehicle bay. And then we've got one out of what looks like the three sections of the Cyclops. Then we need to find two more pieces of the other two sections. And looks like we can build the moon pool. Let's see what we got. Lubricant, two lead, and titanium ingot. See if there's any more.
Passing 100 meters. Oxygen efficiency decreased. Seconds. Welcome aboard, Captain.
Did not see any more of the pieces we'll need for that propulsion cannon. And Moonpool, we don't have any reason to use that right now. So if we can find another propulsion cannon, that'd be cool. But for right now, let's go see if we can actually get inside this.
planets in this region are sparse. The Aurora's radioactive fallout will have devastating effects on the alien ecosystem if not contained within the next 24 hours. Warning, ship structural integrity is low. Fire suppression equipment and laser cutters may be required. Exploration is conducted at your own risk.
So we are in. Let's.
Aurora systems are running on local reserve power, unable to remotely download black box data. New blueprint acquired. Integrating new PDA data. PDA data. Integrating new PDA data.
You see, you want to investigate everything. So that was administration. I do believe we got that blueprint we were looking for. Let's see, what does it require? 2 silver, a battery, and titanium.
Damage to the Aurora do not match any known advanced technologies.
$14.54. Go.
integrating new PDA data. Integrating new PDA data.
That unlocked a Subnaut? That's one of three, okay. So that's module. Yeah. Picked up.
Warning, local radiation at maximum tolerable level. New blueprint acquired.
All right, we seem to be able to seal these breaches.
Breach repaired. Further breaches detected.
All right, let's go ahead and repair the breaches.
Containment breach repaired. Further breaches detected.
Contain the breach repaired. Further breaches detected.
Drive core reduced. Radiation levels decreasing.
So we've contained the breaches in the engine room, and we need something to cut through that door. So, sea moth, we need one more sea moth. One more engine and two more hull. One more mobile vehicle bay. And let's see, what do we need? Stasis, right?
Seek fluid intake. That's cool.
We need a wiring kit for the propulsion kit. Okay. I think I can do that wiring kit. Thank you. nice to use the dead battery. Perfect. Sick. Drop off the stuff we don't need to take in with us.
Thank you.
100 meters. Oxygen efficiency increased.
Oh, that is cool. But we don't have time to admire that right now. We need to get to this base over here to drop off the spoils of what we have gathered here in Subnautica.
This is Life Pod 6. I have a passenger on board. Coordinates attached. We've landed a kilometer from the crash site, but there's radiation in between us and the rendezvous. Request immediate assistance. Six out.
Signal coordinates corrupted. Approximate transmission origin recorded to data bank. Seek fluid intake.
All right. We have got our spoils from the Aurora so far. We have, looks like two areas we cannot access because we do not have something to cut through a metal door. All right, here is what we have got from the Aurora. We have a few batteries, a sample analyzer, a microscope, some flask, Seamoth death module, and a Cyclops engine efficiency. We also have a bronze suit poster. We made ourselves in our beacon, and our main things we'll be looking for next time will be the mobile vehicle bay, the Seamoth, and whatever cutting device we can find to cut through them doors. And let's see what we've started getting the Cyclops, but that looks like that's going to be a little bit ways out. And we were able to find all the fragments in the moon pool, so we'll be building that once we get the mobile vehicle bay built. And we got a power transmitter so we can transmit power farther deep, I believe, because once you get so far underwater, it will start getting less and less power. And then we'll need to look out for the modification table also. So let's play our last radio message and see what's happening.
This is Ozzy from the cafeteria. What the hell, guys? They didn't warn us this might happen. Our pod was almost crushed by the Seamoth Bay on the way down. Now we're hanging on the edge of a cave system, and this grim-looking snake thing's trying to eat through the hull. Come get us already.
Signal location uploaded to PDA.
All right, that is Life Pod 17 out there. We'll be investigating him next time. But for right now, that will be our objectives. And so, signing off here at Dungeon Port Studios. Good night.